Food scientists and processors continually measure the pH of food products and ingredients. pH is measured using pH meters or pH paper test strips. These test strips are very convenient, you know, easy to use. They're not very accurate. They give you kind of an idea of what the pH will be of a food, so you can continue to work on your product. So with this, we simply dip it in instantly. We have our results. We compare them to the color chart, and this is between 2 and 3 on the pH color chart. So once again, we don't have quite the accuracy. So if we want to be more accurate, we would use a meter such as this, particularly if we're working out in the field. And these are very commonly used. This one, these two are probably a little bit more user-friendly than this here. If you were doing research, you'd have a real fancy, high-sensitive benchtop meter. So to begin with, we have to always calibrate our meter. We're doing a 2-point calibration, and we're using a 4.01 buffer and a 7.0 buffer. And the other thing that we need is water, and this meter uses just regular tap water, but always look at the directions that come with your meter and be familiar with what you need. So to begin with, we'll rinse this off, and we look at the display panel, we turn it on, and right now, this display panel is in measure mode, M-E-A-S, it says on the display panel, so we press the cal button, and we now have it in calibration mode. We rinsed it off, I'm gonna dab the tip a little, then I will put it in the 4.01, and when the top number starts to hover, you know, closer to 4.01, and starts to stabilize, that is when I press hold enter. Okay, it's kind of hovering about 4.05, 4.06, okay, 7, 8, here we go. So now we have that. And notice I left it in there when I pressed the hold enter button. Sometimes people want to take that out of the solution, then press hold enter. Now for the second part of the calibration, I leave it in calibration mode, I don't take it out, and once again, it will naturally start to find 7.0. Okay, well, okay, that's pretty close. There we go. I'll rinse it off. And for now, I'm just going to store this pH meter in the water, in the beaker of water, while I prepare the food that I will be testing. When home preserving foods, use a tested recipe so you can home can with confidence. The United States Department of Agriculture and land-grant universities such as South Dakota State University and companies that use USDA guidelines are examples of credible sources. Also visit the SDSU Extension iGrow website, igrow.org, for more information on food safety and home food preservation.